Thank you, Muriel. Judge Muriel Robinson is here. The phone lines are now open and time to get answers to your legal questions. As always, good to have you with us.
Good to be here today.
We have Patty with us right now. Patty, thank you for watching and go ahead.
Yes, my question is, how is somebody held at the Davidson County Jail that has no new charge, has no bond set, and has no bond hearing, and even the sheriff's office doesn't know why he's there because he doesn't have a charge? How can that happen?
Well, you know, it could happen because sometimes people will slip through and papers get lost and whatever like that. When I was handling my jail docket, I always checked after I sentenced someone to make sure they were in there the correct days and make sure they certainly got out at the end of my sentence. But sometimes this happens. There is something that's holding that up, and you're not going to the right person. So what I would suggest is that you contact the district attorney's office, because they're the ones that prosecute people that when you get to the point where you're going before a judge and receive a jail sentence. So first step is go to the district attorney's office, get all the information and facts that you have, and they'll trace it down.
Okay.
So you can call the district attorney and say you need to talk to someone, you've got this problem.
Okay.
Okay?
All right, we have Sue with us. Sue, you're on the air live. Go ahead, please.
Hello. I was calling to ask about the no-lawyer divorce in Tennessee. If you have your children are grown and you have no financial or property in common, what the cost is in the process.
She said no lawyer's divorce.
Oh, a no lawyer's divorce. Well, there is such a thing. If you don't have any property and your children are grown, you can get a form from the clerk's office that's a divorce form that has a form property settlement agreement, and that would be very easy to do. So I would try if you're in Davidson County, I would try the circuit court clerk's office about a form. You can also get them over the internet. So I don't know that site, but I know mm-hmm. that you can get those forms. You might have to modify it if they've printed a county and you mark it out and put Davidson or
okay.
Wilson or whatever your county is. But try those two things, and then if not, you can find you a lawyer that says this is a nothing, and try to find one from the legal aid that,
okay.
that would do it at a reduced charge. But there are forms for it.
All right, fantastic. We'll get one more in. Maddie, go ahead with your question, please. Maddie, you're on the air live. Go ahead, please.
Yes, I have a question. I have a sister that bought a house with a husband. They've been separated for about 35 years. She don't know where he is. His signature is on the house. What can she do? She can't sell it or do anything without his signature.
Well, if he's lost, are they divorced?
She's off the phone now.
Okay. Well, if he's gone, first of all, he may have abandoned her or whatever, and she may have grounds for divorce, and go ahead and get the divorce. The court can give her the property and divest any interest he has therein out of him into her. But if he's just gone away or whatever like that, she could file a chancery suit to quieten title. She is an owner. Some realtors might list it without his name, but his name is on the deed. That's what her problem is. But if he's gone, you know, he may be dead or deceased.
Okay.
And it's been after 7 years. She might clear that title and sell that real estate.
All right, fantastic.
Yeah.
It's always great to have
you
with us. If you didn't get through on the phone lines today, keep in mind Judge Robinson is here every third Tuesday of the month.